All right, hello everyone. Welcome to day 10 of Admin of Code. We're about 2.5 minutes out from the start of the problem. What have I been up to today? Well, I wrote an exam, so I will be giving that tomorrow. That was interesting. I also obviously had to work today, and then was working on Instagram Infinite Backfill. And then I also had some time to improve some of my test infrastructure. So now I have better auto submission logic. So if I disable this line here, then it will automatically it'll automatically submit, and if it's right, it'll write it out to a file and then it won't ever submit again. It'll check for the existing output and make sure that it's correct. I guess I should have an else case here. Let's do this in red. Yeah, that seems right. Let's do that. And that. And let's do that here. And here. Okay. All right. Yeah, that's going to be it. Get my get input script ready. Oh, the other thing that's changed, I have the chat here now. So if you're on YouTube, come over to Twitch. I'm streaming live every day at 10 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. So let's get going. All right, what do we have? Oh, crap. Okay. Okay, single register starts with 1. Okay. That's going to be important. Let me copy these in. Okay, in this test, the cycle number multiplied by x. During the 20th, every 20. Okay, let's just take this test case. Sum of the signal strengths. Okay. type no op at x. Strings dot fields line if f switch on f zero case no op d dot ops dot append op type no op zero. Type add x, and then val is lib dot two int of f one for op. X is 1 if op equals no op continue else op dot x Okay, so x finishing at I plus 1 can there be multiple? I don't think so. X plus equals I and then if I mod 20 equals 0 and plus equals x. What is the expected output supposed to be on this? Shoot, test case. Probably the last iteration, right? Shoot. 420. So in the 20th iteration, it has 36. That's definitely not right. Do I do it before? Okay. Okay, iteration 0 has value of 1. Let's just so test 2, the value should be 0, I think. Or no, it should be 1. Actually, hold on. Is it just that I need to do I plus 1? No. Wait a second. Oh, hold on. So 0, 1, 2, it's still 1. Okay. Oh, it stalls. I guess that makes sense. Okay, so I guess it just stalls. Oh, shoot. Shoot. Right, because it could be intervening. Stop. So if the length of the ops is less than how am I supposed to do this? That's wrong. That's not supposed to happen. How am I supposed to do this? Oh, I need to like actually do the operation. That's not right. Okay, so this is right now, so that's good. Let's see, why is this not working? Okay, so let's just comment these out. Yeah, doing the operation is quite helpful, isn't it? 420. Oh wait, am I just put wait, hold on. Did I just read the problem wrong? Oh my gosh. Ugh. If or block mod 40, wait, no, block minus 20 mod 40 equals 0, then we do this. Oh, that's so annoying. That's really annoying. Cool. So what's up on part two? Three pixels wide. No such thing as vertical position. 40 wide and 6 high. CRT draws the top row pixels left to right, then the row. Okay, so just it's a scanner. Okay, like a actual CRT. This is really confusing. I don't really know how to. Okay, so I guess it does it loop back? X register sets the horizontal position of the middle of the sprite. Okay, well, I mean, let's just copy all of this in. Like, it's not like we're not gonna need it, but now there's like complicated stuff that we have to do, and I don't really understand it. So, let's see. I guess I need to represent my CRT. That's a good start. If I put it in the right place, CRT. And I'm gonna do this as a list of room for. Okay, let's print out the CRT just to make sure. That looks like a CRT screen to me. Okay, so now on each cycle, we actually do something. Really, I should represent this as a single list. Times 40. And then I can flatten it later. And then I need my. So where did it start? It starts at 1. Oh. X is just my sprite. Okay. If sprite equals PC or sprite minus 1 equals PC or sprite plus 1 equals PC, then. var times CRT PC equals hash. That's not right. Oh, oh, shoot. So what is the answer supposed to be here? I think it's probably fine. I'm just gonna go 0, 0. Well, this is not a number. That's pretty obvious. Oh no, PC is not what I want. Clock is what I want. This is not good. Wait a second. That's promising? Am I just doing my indexing wrong? Yeah, no, it's all 46s. Okay, so it is all dots. I'm not doing that wrong, at least. I'm just not going far enough. Oh, hold on. Hold on. I guess maybe the sprite only like is on the line. Okay. That's closer. Is that right? Let's copy this in. I'm just going to trust that this is right for the first one. Oh, shoot. Shoot, what is it? Let's just do it as a string. This is going to be horribly slow. I really don't know what I'm doing, honestly. Let's do this. Okay. So let's now we just copy this. I think this is probably the way to it's probably worth it to spend this time to get this right. I need to think about my test infrastructure because it is a little bit bad. So there's some missing. Oh dear. Maybe. Okay, test one should probably be. Let me think about that. X is on one. So assume zero. So, yeah, I have a feeling that it's supposed to be. rendering this. Darn it, that's so annoying. Let me add a whatever. X is one, second cycle. Is it one indexed? It's not one indexed, because it says down here something about pixel zero. Currently being drawn. So is the top row correct? No, the top row is not even correct. Okay. Top row is just not right. That is a good hint, I think. So what is wrong about it? It's always 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's always the trailing one. Guess. One, one. Oh my gosh. I think it just, hold on. Everything starts as off. Does that matter? Like, I don't, if the spread, like, I don't ever set it back to dark. I guess I don't have any notion of that. I didn't think I needed it, because, like, one, one. Oh, I just need to probably, actually copy paste like correctly. That's probably what it is. There we go. Oh my gosh, I forgot about that. That's really bad. Okay, there's got to be a better way than copy and pasting all the time. I don't know how to do this. Oh, that was horrible. That was so horrible. Man. Ten seven. Ugh. Ugh. This Jaden is doing really, really well. Yeah, the clocks equals zero thing was annoying, but then like I also just didn't check like after incrementing the clock each time. So that was the real problem. I just deleted the I had my copy pasted clock all over the place, or clock checks. I guess I probably don't need this one. I sort of unpasted. I did that wrong. Yeah, okay, so let's figure out how to deal with these test cases in a less insane way. And then I guess I'll pull in. I guess I'll just make them strings. I think that's the way to go. Well, shoot. That's annoying. How do I do a multi-line string? Thanks for coming by, Joshua. Oh, I guess it's the tilde. I knew that. Oh, because it's a string. Let's do this. Dot replace all Yeah, my test infrastructure is not designed for this. I hope there's not any more problems like this. Shoot. What? Why did it get replaced by tabs? Oh. Where are the spaces? Oh, they're there. Huh. Okay. There we go. Okay, so passing both tests. Now I'll make this the same. And then okay, and then I guess the next part is to copy all that and put it in the output. Why is it not equal? My sort of, Oh, I need to put a string around it, I think. Okay. Okay. All right, my test infrastructure kind of let me down on this, because it's really designed for numbers. Yeah, so the off by one error was annoying, but that wasn't honestly the major problem. It was the fact that I didn't check. All right, what's the damage like as far as the actual standings? Oof. Just made it under 5,000. Hey, that was bad. I'm not even, like, I don't know. I'm not even that disappointed. Like, this was just kind of I'm sort of disappointed, but, like, I don't know. What is there to do? Okay, there's got to be a better way of doing this. So, what I couldn't figure out is like how to deal with the fact that ads only increment clock and do not increment the program counter for one iteration. I am a little bit dis okay, one thing that I am disappointed with, it wasn't entirely clear to me that the sprite just like follow it is just the horizontal direction. I mean, I'm sure I was supposed to read something that I just totally missed. Let's see. Yeah. It's this. I read this. I didn't grok it the first time around. Let's see here. So Joshua said that he had some clock function that like did every clock cycle. Let me commit this before I screw something up, because I'm good at that. Twenty twenty-two ten solve. What to do? What to do? What to do? This was just like so ugly. So freaking ugly. All right, let me see. I have an idea. For okay, so PC, so I still need my program counter. Still need X. If d.ops PC. Parsing went well today. Like, I don't even have to change anything about this. Like, I spent the time to actually parse it correctly, which saved me from having to deal with it later on. Let's see here. So no op. PC++. Okay. Okay. That's not good. I don't love this. Where is this error even happening? Line 77? Oh. Ah, right. Okay, one thing that was really annoying was that like it wasn't entirely clear to me that I was supposed to do a stall. Like that was annoying. That was annoying because like I guess knowing about a little bit more about processor design kind of like ruined it. Why are we indexing off the list? Oh my gosh. What am I really supposed to be doing here? Okay, first of all, why is this like breaking? Zero, 1, 1, 2, 2. Where is this? Okay, I'm so confused. 67. There we go. There we go. That's what it is. Don't frickin' increment before you're done. Okay. Yeah, this seems like a better way of doing. I don't know. Is it better? I can't tell. I don't love it. It's a little bit. It is a little bit nicer. I think I like it a little bit better. I think I like it better. Hard to say. I mean, it's just okay. So, is there a way to do this zero indexed and then I guess you just have to switch to different indexing here. It's just sort of annoying that way. Then I just didn't know how sprites worked. So I didn't read that. I don't know. Reading comprehension just sort of like was the entire problem today. That is wrong. Right. Because we're offset. Okay. Let's see. Maybe I should have done it as a list of booleans. I don't know. Okay, this seems a lot cleaner though. Well, okay, so I guess the other thing to do. Maybe I can make this look a little bit nicer. Like make my actual test code a bit nicer. My auto submission on part one worked though. That was really nice. Nah, who cares? I don't want to format this. It's just annoying. Oh, hold on. Yeah, let's just implement something. Maybe I'll do this. And then I can. Have a string function, which turns a string. Return it as a string, I guess. What? Right. So the next thing is making the print work a little bit better, I guess. Actual, so where's the actual? Previous attempt submission. Shoot. Part two. Ah, here. There we go. That looks a little bit nicer. I guess I just need to now. Just copy this. Okay, that looks nice now. And I don't know, this code seems a little bit nicer. Okay, I am a little bit disappointed. Like, I did miss quite a few things. That was sort of unfortunate. But oh well. At least I managed to sort of, I think I managed to at least like avoid total catastrophe, because I was at least top 5,000 still, which is pretty good. I mean, I would love to be top 1,000, but I just don't think I'm going to be able to do that in Go. Or at least not at all reliably. How many points did I lose here? This is the real question, because we're in like a dead heat. I think I gained a couple points. So yeah, 107, 103. I gained 4 points last night. I gained some points that, okay, yeah, so I'm at least gaining on sixth place. And I'm distancing myself from seventh a little bit, giving myself some padding. Jaden, like, again, he just missed a couple days, and so he would be winning. He would be beating me if he didn't skip, but okay, wait, who's this? An anonymous user. Wow, that's cool. Okay, what am I gonna do now? Update the README. Oh, 20 stars now. Pretty good. And yeah, that's gonna be it. Thanks for watching. Oh, question here. How do you see your rank for an individual day? Sorry, I haven't been paying too much attention for the chat. I only have it on this screen. You go to leaderboard and then personal stats. And then yeah, Kelly and Ryan are actually good at this. Oh wait, no, I want, let me see if I can show global score. Yeah, Ryan leaderboarded on like one of the days. I don't remember which one. Maybe day four. Can't remember. Like global leaderboard. And then yeah. I'm not even trying to compete for the top three. Like it's just out of reach. Honestly, top four is really out of reach. Unless like Sam dies or something. Like murder is the only option for me to win. And I don't intend to do that. I like Sam. So, you know, 50 points is pretty impossible to make up down the stretch. But yeah, Kelly and Ryan are quite good at this, as is Colin. I mean, honestly, all these people are good. Like, I mean, anybody doing this is good. So, oh shoot, what did I click on? Let me just check the chat. Yeah, thanks for coming by. Appreciate the support. If you're on YouTube, I do this every night for Adventurer's Code at 10 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. So come on over and follow me. There's a link in the description below, and I will see you tomorrow.